YouTube, hello, my name is Natalie, and in this video we're going to sharpen a few elements in this black and white portrait in Photoshop. Now, the steps here that I will share, I have shared before, and I've been implementing these in my edits for the past 2 years of my photography. It's a method that was shared by Peter McKinnon back in the day, and it's one of the first things I learned to do on Photoshop, and it stuck with me to the point that I turned it into an action. And in this tutorial, we'll go through the steps one by one. Here's our portrait, and the first thing I've gotten into the habit of doing is just unlocking this primary layer here. It makes cropping less of a hassle for me, and as always, we're working in layers, so each new thing we do, we're not doing to the original image and to any of the other layers that come. It's kind of like the Photoshop version of prophylaxis. Do no permanent harm. You can hit Alt and drag this over because it's an individual layer, but old habits die hard, and I'll go with the long route, and that's Alt Shift Control N for a new layer, and then Alt Shift Control E to stamp the layer or to merge all visible layers into one new layer. And I'm going to blur this layer, and I've used this method in a few of my previous video projects. Actually, I duplicate the clip and then apply a blur, and then you'll see the rest. But add a Gaussian blur, and Gaussian implies like a uniform blur, a non-directional, so you could say almost a universal blur. I don't want to say circular, but when I say Gaussian, that's what comes to mind for me, like an evenly distributed curve as opposed to like a skewed or directional one. I don't know, science. A little blur value around 5, and we'll change this layer's blend mode to soft light to introduce a contrast, and let's take this one's opacity down to 50%. Now, this has deepened our shadows relative to the highlights, giving us the perception of a stronger contrast. Now, I often delete this layer when I'm done because I generally add all the contrast I want before we get to the stage in the camera raw editor, but I'm often pleasantly surprised by this step. So I do sometimes keep this, but not this time. But I want this stamped image to base the sharpening on. So let's stamp all of our visible layers to a new layer. So Alt Shift Control N for a new layer, and then Alt Shift Control E to stamp or to merge all visible. If this were a color image, I would desaturate this layer by hitting Control U, but this is already a black and white image, so there's no need. Let's add a blend mode to this to overlay and apply a high pass filter to this image. This means that we're going to create a sort of a grayscale map based on the regions that have high amounts of difference of contrast between dark and light regions. We don't want this value to be too high because it'll just allow all values through and it'll add darker dots all over and it'll kind of sharpen everything. And too low, it'll not pick up any contrast. We want to add these dots to areas of high contrast. So usually 3.5 is fine, and this is based on images that are already edited to my taste, which is already punchy to begin with. So if you edit photos that are less punchy, you might want to increase this value to allow more dots through. And here's what the high pass filter map looks like, and the overlay blend mode will allow for the darker dots to be more visible, or they'll be darker on the image, while the white or the lighter stuff like the earring will appear brighter, and the gray you won't see, giving us the illusion of a sharper image where really we have simply accentuated the contrast. I think let's zoom in. I should have done that from the start and disable or delete rather this layer. I don't want to keep it. And another habit I can't kick, I'm gonna erase any area on this high pass map that I just don't want to introduce any sharpness to, even though you can't see it. This includes our background and her skin. I don't want to introduce any added sharpness to her skin. All right, and let's compare. Look at the scarf first without and now with it back on with the sharpening. Note how we haven't actually sharpened the image, but increased the contrast look at the bright versus the dark in the scarf. And with her face, look at her eyes, off and back on. And her head, off and back on, and zoom out, off and on. And you can decide for yourself if this is a set of steps worth incorporating in your editing process. I've in the past used some of these steps in my video editing where I duplicate a video clip onto a track or a layer above, and then I add some Gaussian blur, change the blend mode to either darken or to soft light, and then I drastically reduce that layer's opacity down. And I don't really do that anymore, but it might be something that you might be interested in trying out if you make videos. And that's it for today, folks. A brief look at faking sharpness by selectively introducing contrast via the high pass filter. If you found this video helpful, useful, entertaining, if you feel that you may have learned something, feel free to let me know down below, whether it's to say hello or what's up. It's all very welcome. Don't forget to keep taking photos, keep making videos. And as always, thank you so much for watching. and I'll catch you in the next video.